hand that I still can't get a level on the anti-spin or anti-spin. The number of pedals is important, just the relationship of the spin. When you're adding more centers of rotation, is everyone clear how you get two centers of rotation in a normal drill? Yeah, and again, it's going to use the Amazon to have it. I've got my quad rotating around my head, and I've got my head rotating around my shoulder. Mechanical limitations in the human body, not necessarily. You've got two circuits, right? Sweet. That's a really sketchy one. When you're adding more than one, direction becomes a problem. So to get hand off lower, if you've got the first circle, path of the hand centre, being clockwise, if you've got counterclockwise, you get a normal flower, like an end the same. And for making this easy when I'm drawing stupid things in my notebook, I started just putting plus and minus. Because in reality, the shape over time makes the same shape as the shape over time, but you have a different direction. So if any spin's going to be plus minus, this spin's going to be plus minus. Yeah. It's going to be the same width, the same bit, possibly different. So just recap really briefly. Is everyone clear how that relates to flowers as opposed to just you moving your hand off the direction? That's a clear enough thing. Taking the flow path and making it the flow path. This is getting towards the oh so popular fractal flower or like a compound flower, or flower, etc. Right? Has anyone not heard those terms before? Sweet. Pretty much, if you take the point path of this one and make the hand path of this one, if you get a third order flower, you're going to take the point path of this one and make it the hand path of the next one. So you go from a circle hand path, a nil hand path, to a circle hand path, to a flower hand path. Drawing these and doing what I just did gets really complicated, because each time you add a center, you add a different starting, right? So you can go four pedal hexagram, you can go three, four, five, six, etc. Or you can go instance. And then counting the down beats and all that stuff and drawing will make it look pretty, pretty difficult. But nonetheless, the very first one I learned was four pedal hexagram. And the thing that got me thinking about how solid the relationship between this one and the next one, which I haven't drawn yet. Shit out of my hand. And I sort of went. I had that a bunch of times. And can you guys see how my hand is still following up my head? Really awkwardly there. And still drawing a full petal flower. But it ends up doing one of these. I'm gonna try to pull this property. Next to me, we're going to drive.
Pink color.
Let's get a brief triumphant interlude. Please do it well. Please do it well.
I won't give you the satisfaction.
You're thinking about it.
I am.
Oh, 10 points. Yeah.
We could be if you want us to, though.
No.
this is a straight end.
Nah, this is the problem. I'm trying to draw too stretched out.
You know what?
What? Hang on. Here's how this is
going.
I need to have the guy.
Yeah, that one. That's what I'm getting at. That is what we're trying to draw and failing miserably. I drew that on a plane too. Like, not like a plane, like on an airplane on a flight while it's tired as all that. That one has extra bits in it. That has the first circle here, and it has the full petal hand spin flower, and it has this shape of. Yeah.
Not to scale.
But yeah, I think I may, yeah, sweet. This is what I was working towards. I'm not going to draw it again because it's difficult. But yeah, I was going, kind of making up my own way to number and name these things, because it was making sense to me at the time. And I was using, again, this plus and minus buttons, right? So this one here was the hybrid I was doing awkwardly there, right? So that had an anti-spinning hand path, and I was anti-spinning along. So I was going to... I'm going to keep that because I'm going to need it later. Ditch all this. So if I have a normal anti-spin, it's going to say it's plus, then minus. To make it an anti-anti-spin, or anti-spin-anti-spin, it's either going to have to be minus, plus, or... Yeah, so the point is, it goes one, then the other, and then the other. So I've got, for my four anti-spin here, if you guys can have a quick look at this page, if you want to check that around. I've just got plus, minus, plus. My first circle was a plus, second was a minus, third was a plus, and now I've got that page is the only point I'm going to check it out. Disperse the groundings. So, actually, three petals is probably a better one, isn't it? Three, because you could imagine you do anti-spins. Yeah, anti-spins. Yeah, so this applies to any number of triangle, right? So if you go a circle, you can old-fashioned trapezoid. One, two, three is going to be that.
No.
I can do this one from the end. I drew it before too.
There you go.
I'm going to try to draw it again now. Messy little one.
And now it's less messy.
Yeah. But see how, like, say the bottom point here, you have almost a trochetra in on itself around this triangle at that point of the trochetra. So this would be a three, I'm calling it a three anti-anti-spring. Because the base pedal, so the base pedal has 3 points and it's anti-spring along the path. I believe you can put more. More or less, you can,
I believe so.
Yeah. Like when you like when we were doing the Unicursals above 7 points and they start to look kind of ugly. When you get above 2 pedals at each of your anti-spin pedal, in your second right here, it starts to look kind of crap. Which is why I like doing this. So that's an anti-anti-spin, right? A cool one to do is the anti-inspin. Also, fun fact, if you make that linear, and you end up with full recovery. That's still technically universal, but it looks... There's a name for it, it's not. But I can't remember why. The point is, it hits all the points and it goes the entire way around once. And yeah. That'd be a linearization of an anti-anti-spin. If you do the same with an anti-inspin, you end up with something really cool and you get a little nerdgasm, which is this pattern.
What?
Yeah. Legend of Zelda fans, what up? Cool. So we're going to ditch the Triforce because everyone knows what it looks like. Actually, yeah, for anyone who doesn't know play Zelda, that was the Triforce, which is a thing from Legend of Zelda. Everyone's played Zelda, everyone can. If you do it as an anti-spin flower, it looks kind of goofy. It literally looks like 3 triquetras stuck in a triforce. So it looks... But kind of like that. So, I drew it really sketch, but... But to do that one, you literally hit the bottom little bit of a triquetra, sorry, of your triforce here. After you've gone through the hallway, you go up the top. Dropping down, shooting across. End up with. And see how that's still got this homology to an inspin. 3 pedals of inspin. 1, 2. See how when your 3 inspin goes around. See how it's got those bits where it's doubling back over itself? And does that the whole way around, so double that. That's these bits here. It doubles back along that. It doubles back there and there. And it doubles back there and there. And one of the little cool things where you put that and the toroids together is because you know the toroids make straight lines, so it doesn't look like a stupid this thing anymore. It looks like a triforce. Yeah. Triforce. Which is why I was getting all like happy when I was like putting stuff together because. You can do straight lines with cool shapes like that. Out of things that make curves.
Yeah,
and
throw one thing in there about the triforce.
Yeah.
It also breaks the rule with 2 points. It doesn't break the rule.
3, 4, yeah, because it's an even number overall. Yeah, that's actually a really cool point. Ordinarily, you think if you had 3 triangles, not touching, so if you had 3, not joined. We have 3, 6, and 9 all up. As I said before, when we're doing our anti-band, each time it switches direction. So we're doing a triangle. Starting forwards, 1, 2, 3, going backwards, 4, 5, 6, back to forwards. you'd assume that if you've got three of them, you've still got an odd number being 9, which means it should switch directions. But because you have 9, 10, 11, 12, the line that doubles back and connects them all, you end up with an even number, so it stays, it ends up being 4 as well. So that's good for you. Yes. Another rather nifty thing, this is just me, cool things. Yeah, that was pretty much all the theories and stuff. This is like cool trick time. Has everyone ever seen the diamond, like this thing? I'm going to short that one. Most of you guys will know what a sans diamond. This thing, yeah? This is actually one of the two versions of an 8-pointed unicursal. The one we were struggling to draw so much, actually.
This is the anti-anti.
Four bells of anti-anti spin. So if we take an octagram, sorry, an octagon rather, turn it into an octagram. This one I can't draw off the top of my head. I'm pretty sure it goes. No, straight line, Andy's been straight line, Andy's been straight line.
Oh, you're doing
straight line, Andy's been.
Wait,
is that?
That's not saying time.
Maybe it's. There's a point to this.
Okay.
So that's the Unicursal Octagram, right? There's a bunch of them on the Australian flags. You can do that in and of itself, which kind of looks cool, but because you're getting so many points, it does start to mush together. Which looks kind of crap until you mush them together on purpose. So if I take these two, right, and instead of having them spaced that far apart, I space them really close to the Earth. That just make 1 point. These two, same deal, 1 point. These two, 1 point. These two, 1 point. You've got yourself a diamond, like a diamond ring framework, right? So I do the same thing. I was going a straight line across, and then diagonal, and then you go straight line, diagonal, straight line, diagonal, straight line, diagonal, straight line.